Now we will see the knot tying techniques. Now this is the first is the C loop technique. Now this is the short tail and this is the long tail. This long tail is shaped like a C, and now as this C is facing to the right side, the right hand needle holder will catch this long tail or C loop. And now we have to supinate this right arm like this. This is the supination, and this supination will create this camel arm at the tip of the right needle holder. And now this right needle holder will become passive and left needle holder will pass through this loop, and then it will catch this short tail. Now see, again this is the supination of the right hand, right needle holder. Now the left needle holder will pass through this and loop is made. Now both the short tail and long tail are they are cross and knot is tied. Now the C loop is facing towards the left, so the left needle holder will catch the C loop. Now again the left needle holder, we will supinate the left hand like this, and now after supinating it will become passive. Then the right needle holder squeezes in and loop is made. See once again, right hand needle holder squeezes in, loop is made. Now both the thread are pulled to the opposite side. Now again now she is facing to the right side. Right needle holder will head the tip of the loop, C loop. Right hand will supinate and this camel hump is made, and left needle holder will squeezes in and loop is made, and this is tied like this. And while pulling the thread, we should pull horizontally and not vertically, so that there should be no pull tension at the target. Now C is facing to the left, so left needle holder is holding the C loop. Left hand will supinate, loop is made. Right needle holder will go inside and knot is tied. This is the C loop technique. We should not pull like this. This is the moment we should not be and this is the correct moment. This is the wrong moment. This is the correct moment. Now we will see the O loop technique, and my preferred technique is the O loop technique because one can tie the knots very quickly. Now the long tail is held with the left needle holder, and this is the O, and we have to bring this tip of this left needle holder near the target. Now this is the O, and now this left needle holder is pronated, and this is, now I will demonstrate under wrap. Okay, now this is for under wrap. We have to pronate the left needle holder, loop is made, and this is the piston movement, and knot is made with the piston movement of both the hands. Now this is again the O loop. Now I will be demonstrating over wrap. For over wrap, The lift needle holder should come from above. And now for overlap, we have to do supination of the lift needle holder. Now this is the supination of lift needle holder, and now the loop is made and knot is tied with the piston movement. Piston means to and fro movements of right and left needle holder. First we have to go inside with the left needle holder till this knot is slided from the tip of the right needle holder, and then we have to again pull back this long tail, and we should not pull the short tail. Now again this is the O loop. Now I am demonstrating overlap. This is the piston movement of both the needle holders. Piston means in and out movement of both the needle holder. Now this is under demonstration of again the under wrap, pronation of lift needle holder, loop is made, and with piston movements of both the needle holders, knot is tied. Now one can see with practice, one can very quickly tie few throws, and we don't have to change the instruments. Now see, the using this O loop technique, and when we keep this, the jaw of the right needle holder open, that is called as thumbs up technique or gladiator technique. Now I will be sharing another video, and now this video is demonstrating first with point ABC technique. Needle is held and it is passed through the suturing pad. Now I will demonstrate the O loop technique. This is the under wrap, first under wrap. This is the second over wrap. This is the O loop and over wrap. This is the gladiator technique. For gladiator technique or thumbs up technique, the jaw of the right needle holder is kept open, and it will help you to make the loop. And now note, after making this first under wrap and second over wrap, we should not pull the short tail, but we have to slightly pull the long tail so that this will become the sliding knot. Now I am pulling the long tail, but I am not pulling the short tail so that this knot will slide, and this is called a cinch knot or sliding square knot, and this knot is again secured with few more throws. Now this is again the demonstration of the thumbs up technique. This is the again O loop with under wrap. This is O loop. This is the pronation of left needle holder. making volume and time. Now I will share another video of sliding square knot. Now this is a video demonstrating sliding square knot with polygalactin number 1. Now needle is loaded with point ABC technique. Needle is passed to the suturing pad from right to left, and in laparoscopic suturing one has to be ambidextrous. One should be able to suture with both right and left hands. Now I will be demonstrating O loop technique. Now the long tail is held with the left needle holder, and this is first is the under wrap. Now second is the over wrap, and now the trick is here. Now to make this lock sliding with the right needle holder, one has to hold this long tail just below this knot, and we have to straighten this thread so that the knot will become sliding. Now this knot will slide. Now this knot is secured with few more throws. This is the over wrap, and this is again under wrap. Thank you for patient listening.